पावर स्पेक्ट्रम, पावर स्पेक्ट्रम, यू कैन गेट पावर स्पेक्ट्रम. स्पेक्ट्रम मीन्स फ्रीक्वेंट डोमेन अंडरस्टैंडिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पावर. ओके, पावर स्पेक्ट्रम यू कैन अटेन. ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड स्पेक्ट्रम बेसिकली. डीएफटी यू कैन अप्लाई. डीएफटी ऑफ ऑटोकोरिलेशन गिव्स अस पावर स्पेक्ट्रल डेंसिटी, दैट इज वीनर-खिंचन रिलेशन. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट. सो स्पेक्ट्रल एनालिसिस इज रिलेटेड टू स्टेशनरी प्रोसेस. That means you have to go for short time Fourier transform. STFT you have to go for, basically. STFT you have to go for. Then that gives us the spectral analysis. So those spectral features you will obtain. Still, you are not addressing the non-stationarity there. So non-stationary related characteristics, non-linearity related characteristics, if at all, non-Gaussianity, if there is, all can be addressed by higher order moments next to second order moment. That the power spectrum, corresponding power spectrum to what is that third order moment. Are you following? Second order moment is autocorrelation. Third order moment is called cumulant. Third order moments are all called cumulants, basically. Okay, so that third order moment, that cumulant spectrum, if you take that DFT, if you apply, you get cumulant spectrum. That spectrum is called bispectrum. The third order moments DFT is called bispectrum. Bispectrum analysis, higher order spectrum analysis involves bispectrum analysis. Further, if you take one more moment, higher moment, that is called fourth order moment. The corresponding power spectrum is called trispectrum. With the bispectrum, trispectrum, those bicoherences, these are the various things in that bispectrum, bicoherence. Okay, some parameters are obtained from those, statistical parameters are obtained, okay, from them. And those are called what features? Higher order spectral analysis features, HOSA features. So with these HOSA features, you can identify, you can accurately identify the diseases where you have non-stationarity, okay, non-linearity, non-Gaussianity. Sometimes, you know, phase coupling, phase information is important. Phase coupling properties are required. So they give the higher order spectral features. Okay. And one more important analysis is wavelet analysis. You see, wavelet analysis, what is the difference between what is this time domain analysis, frequent domain analysis? So some better improvements are there in frequent domain analysis. If it is required, frequent domain characteristics, if they are required, you will go for frequent domain analysis. You will have some resolution aspect in the spectrum. The frequency components can be understood, can be distinguished, can be resolved, okay, in the spectral domain. Resolution is an important property in spectral domain. But if you have multiple frequency components, multiple informations, multiple things, every information component, every frequency components, you need to distinguish them. You need to resolve. Not single one resolution is enough. You need to have multiple resolutions in order to know multiple information components related frequency components. So simple frequency domain analysis understanding may not be enough for us in order to know complete what is that called high resolution characteristics, higher resolution characteristics, multi-resolution characteristics. Okay, that is possible in which domain? Time frequency combined domain. Some information, some time domain related aspects, other frequent domain related aspects. Only they are required. Time domain related analysis is required to find out the better and better resolution, high resolution. So wavelets are those components. The wavelets are the components which are based on time frequency domain. Wavelets are based on time frequency domain. That wavelet analysis is time frequency domain analysis. This gives still better accurate information, accurate wavelet coefficients. Wavelet coefficients are representing the related signal, related activity. So the decomposition means wavelet coefficients. Analysis means what? Wavelet analysis means wavelet transforms you are applying, and that decomposition you are obtaining. So that is called wavelet decomposition. Many people have contributed on wavelets. You know, Dabash is one person who contributed on wavelets. Sixth level Dabash wavelet, fourth level Dabash wavelets. Oh, okay, like that. Mother wavelets. There is a lot of theory for wavelets. This itself is a subject. Wavelet analysis is a subject. Okay, higher order spectral analysis is subject. It is one subject domain. This is also one subject domain. You know, this one. So you will obtain the wavelet features. You see, all these are different probings, different techniques you are applying to identify, to recognize different cardiac arrhythmias, including normal signal. So why people go for research? Why people go for research? What is that you want? You want to identify more and more number of diseases. How many diseases how they know? What is the variation from one disease to another disease? There are some variations in morphology. Temporal features vary. That is called morphological features. Some of them vary. Heartbeat rate variability will be there. R peaks, if they vary, if it is not constant distance between R peaks, if they vary, that's called R peak variability. It gives us the heart rate variability, you see, like that. So the motivation for research in this biomedical signals is like this. Okay, you need to know more and more information related to the diseases. For example, we are considering here cardiogram signals, ECG signals. Lot of work is going on in ECG signals, myogram signals, even vibration, joint related problems. Okay, knee joint related problems. Okay, like that. So that is the motivation for people to do the work. The objective of this research is to find out, to distinguish, to identify various arrhythmias in biomedical signals, and distinguish them, identify them, and classify them. That's what. Well, all these are the various objectives. Okay, I have explained in a nutshell way. Okay, I'll explain you. Overview of the research work. This is what the overall research work overview. You see, the entire research work is put in this block diagram. What is the first step? Pre-processing. You see here, ECG signal pre-processing. You eliminate all sorts of unnecessary, undesired components. You use denoising methods, noise elimination, artifacts elimination, baseline wanderer noise elimination, okay, power supply hum elimination, okay, then you go to the feature extraction process. So time domain, spectral domain, bispectral domain, wavelet domain, all the features are extracted. Okay, feature extraction, then feature selection. Actually, features, when you are obtaining, when the ECGs are multiple arrhythmias, ECGs are given here, all features are extracted. All features are extracted here. So these selected features, sometimes you require feature selection. Okay, after extraction, you require some feature selection. There will be common features overall, But specific features to specific disease, they are different. Those features are important to identify that specific disease. That's what. So you need to classify with those feature selections. Okay, you will use the classification. The classifiers are neural network classifiers. So neural network classifiers involve some learning process like supervised learning process, okay, and unsupervised learning process, okay, some training, some testing like that will be there in this, what it is called, neural network classifiers, okay. So this is what actually, you are giving ECGs in both here. One part you are giving to the training part you are taking. You are training the features. Actually, when you are using the neural networks, these are important. Training part is important. Some testing part is also important. Okay. You train the data, keep all the features of the data in that, and you give the test data, test ECG data, complete the pre-processing, and extract the features of the test data. Now, the test data only you are testing and you are identifying actually. This is done and this is stored in your system. These trained features are all stored in the system. Now you are giving the test ECG data for identifying your various arrhythmias. Then you are coming to this, okay? And the features are compared, okay? So they are given to the neural network, and the neural network, depending on the multi-layer perceptron, radio bases, what is that, radio base functions, random forest algorithm are using, whatever, they are all some of the neural network classifier techniques, okay? Now latest techniques are convolutional neural networks are there, deep learning neural networks are there. In that you have convolutional neural networks, okay, deep learning methods, machine learning methods and machine learning techniques are also there, which are used for classification of these features. This is the basic diagram of the research work flow. This is all shown here. Okay, you see here, time domain analysis features. What are the features in time domain? We are using the word temporal features. Some literature, some contributors, some others, they have used the word morphological features. Can we have some simple difference between temporal and morphological? Can we have some simple difference between temporal and morphological? Because basically both give the similar information, but with little difference. Morphology means that the time-related characteristic related through and through. Okay, those are all called morphological features. Morphology means that variations in the behavior, characteristic variations, behavioral variations. Okay, those are called morphological variations. Temporal means those instant points, number of R peaks, the data, R peak value, amplitude, okay, R peak amplitude, Q amplitude, S amplitude, intervals, duration of intervals, RR interval, and from that interval, people calculate the heartbeat rate. All these calculations, numericals, all the numerical values, the peak amplitudes, I think they're all given the name temporal features, temporal related characteristics, particularly. But characteristic smooth and slopes, smooth parts, slopey parts of the one beat, one ECG signal, they're all totally, it is called a morphological characteristic. That's how I understand this slight difference in the meaning of temporal and morphological. If somebody is interested in further insights, one can go into details. Temporal, morphological, there are, according to the context, people will use these words, morphological word and temporal word. That's what I understand. Coming to the spectral features, spectral analysis, you see, what are the features in spectrum? Mean, these are all statistical, no? Statistical parameters, mean, median, standard deviations, how much energy involved, okay? All these are the spectral related features. Bispectral related features, bispectrum, that is, okay, bispectrum, bicoherence, quadrature phase coupling, these are all, okay, higher order related spectral analysis related carrot. Features, HOSA features. What are the HOSA features further? What are the HOSA features further? Skewness, kurtosis, and some other things are there here. Okay, these are called statistical measures in the HOSA features. Coming to the wavelet analysis, six level wavelet and diverse wavelets are used in this work, in our work. The wavelet features, you see, detailed high frequency coefficients, okay, levels, 1 to 5 levels, approximate low frequency coefficients, energy retained, how much. You know, in the wavelet, in the wavelets, we are using decimators and interpolators. Yes, decimators are used. There are filter banks used in wavelets, you know. Okay, okay. So, first level, second level, third level, okay, decimators are used. Some low frequency, high frequency components are divided, given the input signal. In the first level, you have low frequency, high frequency components. Further, the low frequency components are further, in the second level, they are divided into further low and high. Again, low frequency components will take. In the third level, you will have low frequency, high frequency, partition actually. So, like that, you are acquiring all high frequency related coefficients, detailed coefficients, as well as low frequency related coefficients you are acquiring. And all those are called wavelet features. The energy retained is also obtained. Okay, so like this. And there are database details here. Okay, so the database details, where we have got all this data for doing this work, okay? They're all available in the PhysioNet. So NSR data has been collected from MIT BIH data, and SVT has been collected from MIT data, and atrial fibrillation data, ventricular tachycardia data is collected, ventricular tachycardia data is collected. All these are the sources of the database. And 1 minute duration and sampling frequency dates is also considered. Here, all these you have to understand actually. One important point here we have to share. Okay? How much time duration you will consider for ECG signal? How much duration data you will consider? When you are doing research, you take up the data of various disease, various arrhythmias, a constant time data you take. Suppose I am taking 1 minute data, you take all the data 1 minute. Normal sinus rhythm data, if you take 15, 20, after all 15, 20 or nothing, actually you have to go for a very big data size. The larger the data size, can you guess the information? If the data size is larger and larger, what happens? If the data size is larger and larger, that means the recordings are larger and larger number. Okay? Of the same duration of data, 1 minute data, for example, your statistical measures, metrics, parameters, whatever you are observing from the features, they are better and better. No? The statistical parameters will be more accurate with large data size, no? People, do you agree with me? We have more data, large data size samples. Madam has taken here 15 data for every day, every arrhythmia, normal, everything. 15 data we have considered. 7 arrhythmias we have considered. 7 into 15, 105 data we have considered. Each one is with 1 minute duration we have considered. Okay? people can share with me your ideas. Okay, like no large database, large size data, database size. Second aspect is, suppose you are collecting 10 minutes data, 10 minutes data if I collect, okay. Instead of doing the processing with the 10 minutes data, okay, I can do some segmentation. The large time duration data I can have, I can partition the large data, large duration data into certain segments. That is called segmentation, segmentation of data. Okay, I can have large number of segments. Let me have large number of segments. Each segment you apply these techniques, all the time domain, pan-Tompkins algorithm, and this HOSA and frequent domain wavelet, everything. For each segment you do, and then obtain the statistical measures. All those features you obtain. Okay, that is one way. Using segmentation is one way, or taking large data size is another way. All these can be done. Still more number of diseases you can observe, not only 7 or 6, whatever we have considered here. Still 2-3 more may be there, latest. What about the other diseases? People can go for them like that. So these are the record numbers, okay, etc. So the tools used in the madam's work, she had done like that. So cardiac arrhythmias, so these are all the existing, everywhere you have to put the existing literature, you know. When you are doing a research problem, issues for your research problem based on the limitations of the existing literature, existing contributors. There are 3 to 4 papers before you are coming out with a issue, with a problem formulation, with certain motivation, you know, for your research. So you find out the limitations in every contributor. All those limitations, maybe your issues, maybe issues in your proposed work. That's what. Okay. So there are limitations. Like this, you have to put who are the contributors, what is the publication, you describe their work, you give their plus points, you give their limitations. Like this, all the category: paper, others, publication, description of the work, contribution, advantages, limitations. Advantages, limitations, all the limitations. But all these, with all the limitations, okay, the all the limitations are to be overcome in the proposed work. You know, these steps you see here, after collecting the data, baseline wander removal, band pass filters usage, high pass filter usage, squaring the amplitude, you get the power, moving window integration process, then you are getting odd peak detection. These are all some of the parts are elimination of the undesired signals, baseline wander removal, and you are using a band pass filter, because you know one important point in this contribution is R peak amplitude. So a band pass filter to get your QRS complex, then use a differentiator, a high pass filter, ultimately you get the R peak detection, because this is a part in your QRS complex wave. So for that wave, you are getting the, you are detecting the peak of this R in this Pan-Tompkins algorithm. Okay. So like this. Like these are all various signals. You see, 6-7 arrhythmias are taken, no? These are all various signals. So R peaks are varying. Here R peaks are varying. NSR, CI, SVT, BT, AF, BF, SEA, and like that. So the averages we have obtained here, average values of the temporal features, you see, in the 105 records, there are 15 NSR records whose RP calibrations are like this. RP average 2.4726 millivolts for 15 records of NSR 15 records. Here these are 15, these are 15, these are 15. These are all various R peak values. You see, they are all differing for different arrhythmias. For normal sinus rhythm, this is the amplitude. Average number of R peaks, average RR intervals, average heartbeat rate, like this. So these are all the features, the temporal features obtained. With the help of the temporal features, these are given to the neural network classifier, and these are all shown graphically. RR interval variation of different cardiac signals, like this, like the RP amplitude variation, standard deviation of RR intervals of cardiac signals, heartbeat rate variation of cardiac signals, okay, like that. Then we are applying to neural networks. So these are the neural networks used. Basic functioning of a neuron, random forest type of structure, neural network structure. Random forest algorithm is used for that structure. Multi-layer perceptron one and the random radio basis function like that. So further details are like this given. Okay. So I would like to know whether Dr. Rama joins here now.
Good morning, sir. Good evening, sir.
Rama, are you there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, would you go back some of the parts, or would you continue from here?
I'll give some briefing, and okay, sir. So, overall idea you have given, I heard everything. Okay, this is good. Only few points I would like to raise here. Can I share my PPT, sir?
Rama, are you sharing the screen?
I'm going to share my screen, sir.
Okay.
Can you
stop
sharing this?
I will just listen for some time, okay? I will
be there. Sir. Okay, sir.
Okay. Right.
Is it visible to all of you?
No, ma'am, not yet.
Okay. Why it's not?
Now it is visible, madam. Now it is visible.
Okay.
Tama madam, welcome madam. First of all, many congratulations madam for getting